Hi guys, this is the third video of the video series Normalization, and in this video we are going to talk about second normal form. For a table or dataset to be in second normal form, there are two prerequisites. The dataset should be first normal form compliant and there should not be any partial dependency. That is, non-prime attributes of the dataset should not be dependent on a portion of the primary key. So as we always do, let's understand this with a real practical example. And if you have not watched the first two video of this video series, please watch them as well. I will drop a link to them in the description. So this data set is for an organization that offers multiple courses and multiple students have registered for these courses. So Vivek, who has the student ID 1, has registered for the course name Power BI, which is taught by teacher ABC, and the course fee is 100. So here the student ID for Vivek is 1 and the course ID for course name Power BI is 1. Vivek has enrolled for another course Python, which is taught by PQR, and the course ID is 2. Another person, Sam, has enrolled for the same Power BI course. The student ID for Sam is 2. Sam has enrolled for another course for R and the course ID for this course is 3. So the course ID 1 has the course name Power BI, which is taught by ABC. 2 has the course name Python, which is taught by PQR. And course ID 3 has the course name R, which is taught by XYZ. We have another person, Rick, who has enrolled for the same Power BI course. He has also enrolled for Python and Rick has decided to go the extra mile. So he is also learning SAS. So we have three students which are studying these four courses that are being taught by three different teachers. So for this data set to be in second normal form, the first prerequisite is that it should be in first normal form. And a dataset is in first normal form if it complies the following requirements. There should not be any multi-valued attributes. For example, Vivek is pursuing two courses. If instead of having two rows, we had a single row and the course name Power BI and Python was specified like this, then we would have had a multi-valued attribute. In this dataset, I don't see any multi-valued attribute. The second requirement is that there should not be any duplicate rows. So as we see, all these rows are unique, so this requirement is also met. The third requirement is that all the values should belong from a specific domain. For example, it should not happen that one of the rows of the column course ID contains Power BI or a phone number. So this dataset also complies with this requirement. Every column has value from its specific domain, so we are good. And the final requirement is, there should not be any specific ordering, top to bottom or left to right, which is the case. We also have a single value in each cell, so this dataset is in first normal form. The main objective of this video is to identify if this dataset is in second normal form, and if it is not in second normal form, how do we make it to second normal form? So as the definition says that no non-prime attribute should be partially dependent on a portion of the composite primary key, the first thing that we need to do is we need to identify what is the primary key of this dataset. Is student ID the primary key? No, it is being repeated. We have two IDs for 1, 2 for 2 and multiple IDs for 3. So that cannot be the key. Student ID and course ID can be considered the composite primary key for this dataset. Now one may argue, why we are choosing student ID? We can choose student name and course ID, right? That also seems fair. This also looks unique, but imagine we have another student with the same name Vivek, and if we choose name and course ID, now we may have problems. Similarly, we cannot choose phone number or course name because there is a possibility that this Power BI course is being taught by another teacher, which is why student ID and the course ID is the ideal primary key for this dataset. Now, what are non-prime attributes? The definition says that no non-prime attribute should depend on a portion of the composite primary key. So we know that student ID and course ID together form our primary key. All the columns apart from student ID and course ID form our non-prime attribute. So name, phone number, course name, teacher, course fee, all these are non-prime attributes. And the definition says that these non-prime attributes should be fully dependent on the composite primary key. But in our dataset, name is dependent on student ID, phone number is dependent on student ID. That means these non-prime attributes are dependent on a portion of our composite primary key. Similarly, course name, course fee, and teacher are dependent on course ID, which is a portion of our composite primary key. This means, although this dataset is in first normal form, but it is not in second normal form, because the non-prime attributes, attributes that are not part of our composite primary key, are dependent on a portion of our primary key. So this dataset is not in second normal form. So how do we make it in second normal form? We can make it in second normal form by normalizing the dataset. Let's quickly review the definition of normalization. Normalization is the process of splitting or organizing of data to reduce redundancy and to avoid anomalies. So we are going to split this dataset to make it second normal form compliant. And guys, if you have not watched my first video on normalization, I will drop a link. Please watch that video as well. So we have this dataset and we know course name, teacher, and course fee are dependent on course ID. So let's create a table courses that just contain data related to courses. The primary key for this table is course ID. Now this table is first normal form compliant, and since it does not have a composite primary key, it is also in second normal form. Actually, it is safe to say that a table which is first normal form compliant and has a single column primary key is second normal form compliant as well. After the splitting of this table, we have this table left, and again for this table, the primary key is the same, student ID and course ID. And here again, name and phone number are dependent on student ID or can be derived from student ID. So this dataset still violates second normal form. We will have to split it further. And guys, if you ever get a dataset and you have to convert it into second normal form, you have to remember this simple rule. If you have a composite primary key and there are non-prime attributes that are dependent on a portion of that key, split the dataset until you reach a situation where none of the dataset is in violation of this condition. So we have this dataset that is still not compliant to the second normal form. We are going to break it and create a table student that has student ID, name, and phone. Here the primary key is student ID, and since it is not a composite primary key and the dataset is in first normal form, this table now conforms to the rule of second normal form. The other dataset that we will create will contain student ID and course ID, and these tables are called bridge tables. They actually build a relationship between our main tables. So here, student and courses are our main table, and this table is acting as a bridge between these two tables. This table has a composite primary key, and since it does not have any non-prime attributes which depend on a portion of primary key, this table is also in second normal form. So if you want to represent this dataset in second normal form, we have to divide it into three small tables: students, courses, and a bridge table that connect these two, and it will be second normal form compliant. Again, let's do a quick recap. For a dataset to be in second normal form, it should be first normal form compliant and there should not be any partial dependency. So here we have a composite primary key and the non-prime attribute name, phone number, course name, teacher were dependent on a portion of the composite primary key. But with this new table structure, these two tables have a single column primary key, so they are by default second normal form compliant, and this dataset has a composite primary key but does not have any non-prime attribute depending on a portion of the composite primary key. Therefore, this is also second normal form compliant. So remember guys, a lot of times during your assessments, exams, assignments, or in your project, you will be given a denormalized dataset and you will have to make it second normal form or third normal form compliant. Or you may be given a dataset along with the dependency between columns and you will be asked to identify if the dataset is in second or third normal form. I will make a separate video where we will solve certain exercises on normal forms. So guys, I hope now it is clear that what is normalization, what is first normal form, what is second normal form. In the next video, we will discuss about third normal form. Thanks a lot guys for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.